till the battle picked me. Misery, like the war of words I shouted in my sleep.
Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. So today is episode 5 of series 2, and I hope you're all doing really well. So at the start of 2024, it's a big year for fashion, and there's been a term around for a while now, for the last year or two, and it's called quiet luxury. So in today's video, I want to show you guys how to build the foundations of a wardrobe based around this term, quiet luxury. So if, like me, you've started this year and you're already on a bit of a fashion journey, and you've been watching YouTubers such as Daniel Simmons, Tim DeSaint, Harry Haas, quite a few to mention, you'll notice that they all have this thing in common where they're dressing really minimal, really smart, and they look really expensive. And I'm going to teach you today how to do that without spending a fortune. So I'm going to show you how to do step by step and build a wardrobe based on the term quiet luxury. Right, without further ado, let's get into the video. So just before I do go ahead and talk you through how to build this quiet luxury wardrobe, I did want to just mention a couple of little points. So first of all, this video can still be useful even if you absolutely hate quiet luxury and you hate that style, because all I'm trying to do with you today is teach you how to build the foundations of a wardrobe that actually works with itself. So the best thing about my wardrobe at the moment is, which I'm going to talk you guys how to do, is I can just take any item and piece together an outfit. And now, you think that sounds silly, but obviously, like, when you do go to make an outfit normally on a day-to-day basis, most people do have trouble. They'll get one item, you'll get another, you might have got spontaneous purchases, different coloured items, and it becomes really tricky to actually make an outfit, especially when you're delayed on time as well, if you're trying to get to work or trying to get out to that meeting. So I feel like this video is really helpful in that term, and that's what I'm going to try and aim for. You don't need to copy my style exactly, you don't need to buy the same outfits and the same items as me or Tim or Daniel or Harry, but basically all I'm trying to do is help you guys build your own foundation based on your own style. And this quiet luxury term, really, it's just trying to get you to buy more long-lasting clothing. It's a bit more ethical, and instead of using fast fashion, you're actually going to have really nice pieces that you can come back to season after season. And that for me is a really big thing, and it's a much better way of dressing than just buying your fast fashion. But obviously I still use that as well, so each to their own. It's just literally a bit of inspiration for you guys, so let's get on with it. Right team, so first part of your outfit got to be your base layer. So we're going to start with underwear. Now, for my underwear, I literally have these basic crew socks, which you can get from Zara. You can also get from Weekday, H&M, any of the high street stores do these, and they are quite long lasting. So to be honest, with the socks, other than Primark, anything above there, H&M, they do last for a good year or two, which is really nice. So I go for these plain white looking crew ones with the ribs, because they go with boots, they go with loafers. They're really nice in summer to pull up with shorts, but you can also wear them in winter with boots because they're quite thick. And then on the boxer front, I've gone for these really nice basic Calvin Kleins. I suggest going for really minimal with your socks and your boxers. I'd go for black or white for your boxers. Same again with your socks, but I think white and off-white much better than black for the socks, and they'll go with everything. On the boxers, the reason I've gone for Calvin Kleins is the quality is just a little bit more superior than getting some high street ones, but I always keep them exactly the same, so they go with every outfit and they don't shine through anything. So I get a pair of each to start my outfit, a pair of white socks and a pair of boxers. Right guys, so the next part of the outfit, you might have actually been expecting trousers or legwear, but for me, the next thing you need to go to is t-shirts or tops. So these ones are from Arkit, and they are the heavyweight cotton t-shirts. They do have some really nice longevity to them. I would recommend the Daniel Simmons Essential t-shirts, but the price range is a little bit too expensive, and for today's video, I wanted to show you how you can do the quiet luxury on a budget. If you did want to spend a little bit more, I think those come in at about £75-80, and I'd go for a black, an off-white, and maybe a brown one. So that's what I've done with the Arkit ones, and these are the heavyweight ones. I do wear them in summer as well. They're not too bad, but you can get the medium midweight ones if you do want some that are a bit lighter fabric. They are cotton and they are nice and long lasting. So what I'd do is I'd recommend getting one black, one off-white or cream, and then picking another colour of your choice. Mine is brown because it goes with my skin tone, but I would recommend a pop colour, blue, green, maybe some earthy colours, just whatever you really fancy. But make sure you stock up on the black and the white one, get a couple of each, and then just get one of your pop colour. The reasoning that I have actually done the t-shirts before the legwear, if you're asking at home, is because obviously, depending on the colour of the t-shirts you've got, they might not actually match with all your legwear. So I'd always opt to pick your t-shirt first. If you're going for a white or black, it's going to go with a lot more. Obviously, if you're going for your pop colour one, then we might have to change what legwear we're going to pick next. Moving on to legwear then next. So what I'll do is I'll start with jeans and then I'll do trousers and then we'll do shorts, because obviously it depends what time of year we're dressing for. So I start with the jeans. So what I'd do with these is I'd always get a pair of black jeans. I'd get a pair of light blue or any type of blue wash, and then I'd get a pair of cream or white jeans. Now with the black and the blue ones, I've gone for a loose fit, not mega baggy like all the trends are doing, just a nice straight leg sort of loose style, so it's not hugging your legs, skinny fit or slim, but it's also not too on the baggy side, so you can get a plenty of longevity out of them. I've done that for the black and the blue ones. Then the white cream ones, because I tend to wear them in summer and I tend to wear them a little bit smarter, I've gone for a slightly slimmer leg on those ones, so they're a straight leg. But for you at home, I would recommend definitely getting one pair of black wash jeans, one pair of blue wash jeans, and then maybe an extra pair of either cream or a colour of your choice, even brown or a wash brown. So just to talk you through the jeans a little bit closer, the blue ones are Abercrombie & Fitch ones, so these I highly recommend. They do fit sort of true to size, so I think mine are a 31 with a 32 leg, and I do like the way they sort of sit a little bit over your shoes as well, so I like a little bit of a longer length in my jeans. The black ones are Weekday Official, so those ones are a similar fit to these, just a different branding, but I highly recommend going on Abercrombie and Fitch for your jeans. You can get all three of these type of jeans and all three colours on there, and they're all an affordable price. Then these ones are just from Zara. I wouldn't massively recommend Zara for legwear. You have to go in store and try it on, because the fitting in jeans is all over the place in the legwear. Some of it's too big, some of it's too small. So I'd highly recommend sticking with Abercrombie for your jeans. As well as jeans then, you're going to need some trousers. So trousers for me are actually just as versatile as jeans. So I think you definitely need to make sure you put these on your quiet luxury wish list. So I would start with one pair of black, one pair of dark brown or a chocolate brown, and then a nice light summery one in a cream colour or a beige colour. So the black and the brown are the exact same trousers from Weekday Official, and they are the Conrad trousers. I do think they do a similar one, maybe called the Uno. I haven't tried those, but they're a new style as well. So these ones are nice and pleated, so they've got that smart look to them, and they're a loose fit. So again, not going for slim or skinny, just a nice, steady, loose fit, so you can bring them out year after year. And then the beige ones are from H&M, and I think they were a steal of a price. You can get them around £20, and they're just a nice summery linen trouser, also with a pleat. So all three trousers, really good to put in your wardrobe, and definitely on the wish list. Just a little close-up of the trousers then, these Weekday ones. So just to show you that pleat running down the middle. What I really like about the trouser section of your wardrobe is you don't actually have to spend a ton of money to actually make yourself look expensive with these. So I think these can be around £30 each. But straight away, just having that nice pleat detail, having, you know, contrasting buttons, nice fabrics such as the linen, it can really bring out your outfit and make it look a lot more expensive than it is. So highly recommend you get all three pairs of trousers from wherever you can. Next part of legwear then, you need some casual legwear. So you're going to need at least two pairs of sweatpants. So I'll give you a little bit of a close up of the ones that I've picked. So I've got these Cole Buxton Grey Marl ones. Now, just to recommend with these, I've gone for the ones with the cuffs. You can go for straight leg ones. I always recommend spending a little bit more money on this section of the wardrobe, because if you go for cheap Grey Marl, you can normally tell and it doesn't look nice. So if you go to a high street store such as H&M or Weekday, you can normally tell that the colouring's all strange, whereas these ones are really nice and thick and you can just tell that they're really supreme quality. So that's Cole Buxton or Daniel Simmons or Florence Black. I would recommend opting for some of those. Like I said, you can go for straight leg ones with no cuffs, or you can do what I've done and get the cuff ones. But whichever way you do it, I'd always get the other colour in the opposite. So I've gone for a straight leg one here with the zips, which are the about blank heavyweight ones. But yeah, so if I went for the grey straight leg ones with no cuffs, then I'd have got these with cuffs. But I've gone for the black without cuffs, and then these ones with. Final section of legwear then for the summer outfits. I've gone for two pairs of shorts. They are exactly identical. They are the Ami Paris Bermuda shorts. They are true to size, so I've gone for, I think, a 31 waist. They're really nice and flowy, and the finish just above the knee. So I've gone for a beige colour, and I've gone for a black colour. So I always recommend getting one pair of light coloured shorts, one pair of dark coloured shorts, and then you could maybe go for a different style. You could go for some denim in black or light blue, or you could go for some type of skater shorts. But I would always go for one pair of beige and one pair of black. Next up then, so we're going to go to shirts. So I've gone for short sleeve shirts first. So I've got a black one, a cream one, and then I'd go for a pop colour again. So I'd just go for a navy blue I've gone for, but you could go for a green, blue, red, yellow, whatever you want to go for. But make sure you've got a nice beige or a cream one and a black one. I tend to play around with the shirts a little bit more in terms of fabrics. So as you can see, as you get closer, I've gone for a bit of a terry cloth style with this one. A bit of a woven look, and then the black one's a nylon look, and then this one's just your normal cotton fabric. So if you do different sort of textures and different fabrics, it can really elevate your outfit. So I tend to do that with all three of the shirts. Just to mention, the black one's from Zara, so is the cream one, and then the blue one is from Folks. That one's a little bit more expensive, but I'd highly recommend Zara for short sleeve shirts. I have an abundance of short sleeve shirts from Zara, and I've got many over the years, and they do last a long time as well. I've not had to get rid of any, so I'd really recommend checking their website out. Long sleeve shirts then. So I've literally just got one draped shirt, which is a really nice cream flowy one. Daniel Simmons does do his own style of these, but they are quite expensive. So this one's a weekday one. And I just recommend getting one nice long sleeve shirt, maybe two at a push. And I'd go for these really nice long flowy ones in the linen style with the cuffs. Moving on to coats and jackets then. So this is where all the fun is to be had. So to start with, I've gone for a dark grey overcoat, but I'd always recommend getting a really nice long overcoat. A wool one would be nice, or a wool blend. This one's a wool blend one from All Saints. I'd go for a dark colour, either black or charcoal, or you could go for a light neutral colour like beige. Then I've gone for a rain mac. This is the classic Burberry trench coat. I would recommend it in either black or beige or tan. Then I've gone for a black small leather jacket, which just ends at the waist, and that one's from Zara. And then I've gone for a thinner jacket, which is for a bit of a warmer day, and that's the about blank cream one. So that's just a cotton jacket. Now, when you're building up your jackets for your wardrobe for the quiet luxury, I'd recommend one overcoat in a colour. I'd recommend one traditional pea coat or traditional formal jacket like a rain mac, such as the one I've picked. Then I'd pick one leather jacket, probably in black. And then I'd pick at the end just a nice summer breezy jacket. Can be anything, just a light windbreaker or a nice cream cotton one as the one I've picked. Next up then, we've got footwear. So with the footwear, you want to go for one pair of smart shoes or loafers. So this could be derby shoes or loafers. I've gone for the base Wegians with a nice silver horse bit. Then you've got to go for a pair of brown boots and a pair of black boots. Generally, I'd go for this Chelsea style because they're nice and easy to get on and off, and they go with all outfits. And then finally, you want a really good classic pair of white trainers. So these are the off-white ones, which are Superstars by Adidas. You could go for the Sambas as well because they're very popular at the moment, but I'd make sure you go for a really minimal branding one. This one's just the classic cream colourway with the black stripes. But yeah, so try not to include too much colour. And just go for some black formal shoes, two pairs of boots in a brown and a black, and then a nice white trainer. Next up then is accessories. So I've just gone for two caps. I've gone for a navy blue one and a dark grey one in a really nice wool fabric. And I've gone for two bags in a Bottega Veneta style from Zara. And they're just a woven brown and a woven black bag. And they're crossbody messenger bags. So if you just get two crossbody bags, you could even use the Uniqlo ones. You could go to any high street and just get plain ones. Try and avoid any logoing or any flashy emblems on there. Then the caps, I've gone for a wool-like style. You can get the Uniqlo one, or these ones are from Camden Market. Also, if you want to spend a lot of money, you could get a Loro Piana one. But sticking with the budget, I've gone for these two, and then these two bags from Zara. Final category then of today's video is going to be knitwear. So this is one of the mid layers you're going to use in your outfits, but it is to me one of the most important in quiet luxury. So this is where you need to up your fabric game and go for things such as wool and cashmere. So at the far right, I've got a grey cashmere jumper from Farfetch, which was a couple hundred pound in the sale. And that one's a zip up, so it's really good for throwing on as a mid layer when it's quite warm and you don't want to put too much on, or even in the winter as an extra layer. Then I've gone next on is the Marks & Spencer's black roll neck, which is 100% cashmere. And that only cost just over £100, which is really affordable. And both those pieces will last a lifetime. Then at the end, I've gone for Emily Ondor jumpers. So I've got the brown and then the oatmeal coloured jumper. So I've gone for two roll necks, one crew neck, and then one hooded jumper as well. So I reckon it's best to go for a little bit of a mixture. The roll necks can make your outfits look a lot smarter. The crew necks can go with a lot more casual outfits. And then the hoodie is just a great throw on in any outfit you need it. So I'd really recommend getting a mixture of these, and I'd go for colours again in greys, blacks, creams and monochromatics. Chocolate brown's a really nice one as well in knitwear. So for the final part of the video then, here is my quiet luxury outfit. So what I've done today is I've shown you with all the parts of the wardrobe, I can take one item from each section and make a fantastic quiet luxury outfit. So I've taken the shoes, which are the Adidas ones, the trainers, then I've took the weekday pleated trousers, the Bottega style bag from Zara, the overcoat from All Saints, the grey cashmere hoodie from Farfetch, the Arkit top, the Zara short sleeve shirt, and then on the top I've gone for the wool light cap. And this proves that you can take any item from that wardrobe I've put together for you today, and you can make a really nice monochromatic quiet luxury outfit. Right guys, that's all for today's video on quiet luxury. I hope you learned something in today's episode, and I hope you did enjoy it. If you did, please drop us a like and a subscribe, and any comments for future video ideas will be appreciated. I'll see you next time. Pushed from the precipice, clung to the nearest lips. Long story short, it was the wrong guy. Now I'm all about you. I'm all about you, I. Yeah, yeah. I'm all about you, I.